My question, Todd, is that you've been here for a couple of days at least, and you might have seen a little bit of this condition of traffic in, if not in India, at least in Delhi. And what would you say is the most urgent thing we could do to improve our transportation system and make it more sustainable?
Right. Well, there's a lot of thinking going on in cities all over the world about how to create transportation systems that are truly multimodal, which means that you can walk, you can bicycle, you can use public transportation, and you can drive or use a taxi when you need it. But it is no longer automobile dependent. It isn't the assumption or the planning doesn't favor automobile transportation at the expense of the other forms of transportation. One way to do that, one of the ideas that a lot of transportation planners and engineers are embracing is what's called complete streets. So right now, when a city or a transportation agency is told to improve the streets, they think that means improving for car travel. The complete streets philosophy says no. When you improve a street, you want to balance the bicycling, walking, public transportation, automobile transportation together. And that a city isn't complete, or a street isn't complete, if it only accommodates driving and doesn't do a good job of accommodating walking and bicycling. Well, I think here in Delhi, it's very clear the streets are not complete.
Right.
In many situations, you can't even walk across the street. You can't even cross the street.
Right.
And now, some streets do have a sidewalk, but the sidewalk conditions are terrible. So they may be nominally 3 meters wide, but then there are telephone poles, there are holes, there are vendors, there are people that are encroaching on the sidewalk. So in practice, it's much less than what it needs to be. Think of it this way. If you want a transportation system to serve everybody, it needs to serve people who are in wheelchairs, people who are using canes, parents pushing a baby buggy. Ask yourself, how well do the current streets in your city accommodate those users? And if you conclude that people with any sort of mobility impairment can't walk around, can't travel on their own, then the system has failed. The good news is that it's actually fairly inexpensive. It doesn't cost a lot to fix up the sidewalks, to put in some traffic calming, some good crosswalks, in some cases some pedestrian overpasses. Those are actually very cheap compared with most of the other kinds of transportation improvements. So there's a very strong case for changing our street design guidelines. The good news is the city of Delhi actually has very good street design guidelines. The bad news is they're not being implemented. So I think you have some opportunities